has bred disorder. The sea rises to flood the pubs and extinguish the street lamps. Our city will die. Tupine has failed. Lucy has failed. Brudenell, Elliotson. Pearl. All have gone into the night. It is up to me now. The assassins have brought nature's fury into our homes. Men have become monsters, barreling toward us, teeth out. Our civilization must survive this onslaught. To prevent a return of the Dark Ages, I will start anew. London must be reborn.
Verification. If we're gonna move, we need to be 100% sure. We'll only get one shot before Otso Berg crashes down on us.
Gotta agree with Sean.
We'll position ourselves near the palace, but we'll wait for you to sync the genetic data before we move.
It's all up to you, Initiate.
You're late. Starrick is making his move. The Peace of Eden is somewhere inside Buckingham Palace.
Let him have it.
I've seen your handiwork across the city. Perhaps you should trust my judgment.
I've been killing Starrick's henchmen. What have you been doing? Let's ask Henry, shall we?
I have been repairing your mistakes. Too much haste is too little speed.
Don't you quote Father at me.
That's Plato. And I am sorry, this doesn't involve anything you can destroy. Father was right, he never approved of your methods!
Father is dead!
Enough! I have just received word from my spies. At the palace ball tonight, Starrick plans to steal the Peace of Eden, and then eliminate all the heads of church and state.
Once more for old time's sake?
And then we're finished.
Agreed. So what's the plan?
Such an unexpected delight to visit you both. What is the news on the street?
Mrs. Disraeli, we have discovered that there is something inside Buckingham Palace that could threaten the...
What my sister's failing to say is that we require entrance into the ball tonight.
Impossible! Even if there were any invitation cards remaining, which there are not, someone of your lowly station...
If that damn fool Gladstone is attending this evening, they can have my card.
Perfect. Then I'll go alone.
Mrs. Disraeli, if you'd be kind enough to inform my darling brother of the location of the Gladstone's residence, perhaps he could use his considerable skills to commandeer their cards.
What fun! Did you hear that, Dizzy? We're going to pinch the Gladstone's invitations!
Thank you for volunteering me, sweet sister.
Oh, a pleasure, brother dearest. Now, Mrs. Disraeli, if you would excuse me, I must visit with the Maharaja. It occurs to me that he may have a second set of plans to a certain vault.
The nerve of Evie. Treating me like a child.
Easy, girl. Easy.
Where can they be? The ball is tonight. They must have taken the invitations with them. Slow down now! You wouldn't happen to have seen two carriages pass by here just now?
I did, sir. One with a man in it, the other with a woman. They split up.
Where did the man go?
That way.
Thank you.
Thank you.
I'm on the right track. Steady on.
Slow down.
Private party event. Don't mind if I do.
Feeding your wife?
Mr. Gladstone can certainly
Mr.
make a
Gladstone
speech.
Mr. Gladstone must be shielded. He's a genius.
Thank you for supporting me and the party.
When will Mr. Disraeli give up the fight? He's certainly outmatched.
We need more moralizing in modern politics.
Indeed we do.
What a lovely dress! Under arrest!
Ha! Ha! Shot!
Suspects on the run!
Get the mustard! Get back here, you bastard!
Probably miles away now.
I've got a bead!
You're too slow! That is a rather pathetic display. Found him!
Delicate as I could have been. But still. Mrs. Gladstone's under guard. Better be cautious. Better wait until she's alone. Is my chance.
He's late.
One should not attend the Queen's ball without making a proper entrance. Now is my chance. Now for the invitations. What's this? Swords must be left at the door by order of the Queen. Freddy will know what to do. Keep moving. That's a girl. Easy does it. Who's a good horse? You are. Let's go. Keep moving.
quite a carriage you got there. Where did you buy it, if you don't mind me asking?
Ask all you want, Freddy. You'll never get an answer.
Damn it all. Was it my eyebrows?
Yes. And your face, voice, and body. Look, I've got an invitation to the Queen's ball tonight.
How did you come by that?
Freddy, there's to be an attack on the ball. I need to smuggle some weapons inside to prevent it.
Supposing I believe you? Only the Royal Guard carries weapons.
So?
Too easy.
For God's sake, Freddy.
Fine. I require a guard's uniform.
Done. I knew you'd come through.
Just promise me, Jacob, that you will return Mr. Gladstone's coach?
Of course.
That's the way.
I hear there will be cake at the Queen's ball tonight.
Cake, he says.
Charming. Now to hurt the body.
suppose you know who did this, do you?
Is that all you can do? Run away?
Look! He's back!
Ready? Here I come. Steady on. Doing fine, girl. That's a girl. Walk on, girl. One uniform as requested.
It's still warm.
My gift to you?
I will meet you on the roof of Buckingham Palace.
You're such a romantic.
Who's a good horse? You are. Let's go. Yeah! Yeah! Easy now.
Delighted to see you again, Miss Fry.
Your Highness, the plans detailing the renovations to Buckingham Palace have gone astray.
I suppose you will have to make do with the copies.
There are copies? Where?
Not so fast. First, I have a matter of some urgency. Carrying out my plan would require stealth and speed, qualities I know you possess.
Time is of the essence, Your Highness.
Then make this quick, my dear. The most influential men in Parliament remain beyond my reach. But these very men have sent for carriages to prepare for the ball tonight. Acquire an official carriage, and we shall drive the politicians to their destinations. Along the way, I will meet with them. And afterward, I shall tell you where to find the plans.
You're a shrewd negotiator.
One must be, when one is so often underestimated.
Don't allow personal feelings to compromise the mission. What a mistake.
Yes.
gotta go. Easy, girl. Slow down.
Shall we lobby our cause?
Here now. Climb up, Your Highness. Where are we headed?
Belgrave Square.
There you go. Come on. Calmly. Here now. Easy now.
Station is and on the double. My son is anticipating my arrival.
Welcome, sir.
Your Highness, what a surprise.
Is life not about embracing the unexpected? I shall take but a few moments of your time. A matter of utmost importance must be discussed. When the Commonwealth seized the Punjab from my people.
It was not a seizure, but a rightful transaction.
Britain promised to protect me. By robbing me of my kingdom, Parliament acted in violation of the treaty signed with my family. Here, read it.
I was not aware.
Read. That is all I ask. You are one of the few in a position to help.
I will do what I can.
Thank you, sir. I trust you and your son will enjoy the ball this evening.
He is newly returned from Delhi. I will share what we have discussed. It is most disconcerting.
That proved quite valuable.
Where to now?
St. James's Park. I noticed Mr. Green did not accompany you.
He has other things to attend to.
Ah, a pity. You two seem to get along nicely.
Well, that was a problem, you see. One must not allow personal feelings to compromise one's mission.
That sounds like a quotation.
It is. From my father.
Ethan Fry.
You knew him?
No, unfortunately. But Mr. Green spoke of him. He sounded like an extraordinary man.
He was, Your Highness.
And your mother as well. Cecily Fry. She and your father were partners, inseparable. The only duo that came close to challenging Mr. Starrick. And very much in love, at least from the small amount I have been told.
Cecily. I wish I could have met her.
From what Mr. Green gathered, you share much in common. Your intelligence, for one.
Father never spoke of her. What would Mr. Green know? He was only a boy when he trained with my father.
Children can be quite perceptive, Miss Fry.
Slowly now.
To Parliament, please. On the double.
Yes, sir.
Good day, sir.
Why, what are you doing here, Your Highness?
I know how busy your days have been of late. A few moments of your time is all I require.
This is all rather unorthodox, but continue.
Britain was to protect me according to the treaty my family signed. Instead, she took my land. And now I hear Britain intends to strengthen her ties to India. Perhaps it is time to return the Punjab to her people.
The Queen has supplied you with an annual income for God knows how long, and now you bite the hand that feeds you?
It is not a matter of money. I cannot stand idle and watch my homeland subjected to the yoke of an outsider's rule. My people are treated as slaves.
Good day, sir.
May God bless you. Only one more remains. To the Gladstone residence.
Do you miss India?
I remember that my mother smelled of cinnamon. And when she cradled me in her arms in the summer heat, I would hold so still that she fell asleep. When I lost my kingdom, it hurt. But truly, when they took my mother away, I saw her again 2 years before she died. The summer long since faded.
What else can go wrong?
I miss her. I miss India. I love India because I love my mother.
Will you ever return?
I have petitioned the government several times, but they withhold their permission. Do not be fooled by appearances, Miss Fry. I am in many ways a prisoner.
Perhaps we may work together more closely for your cause in the future.
I would like that very much, Miss Fry.
To the smithy, go straight away!
Good day, Mr. Gladstone.
Mr. Singh!
You are a hard man to pin down.
I know what this is about. Your politics have worn off. Your Majesty has tired of you. So now you come begging for scraps.
You wound me deeply, sir. My people deserve freedom. I am here to fight for them.
Why did you lose the Punjab? I shall tell you, Your Highness. You were outgunned, outmaneuvered, and simply outclassed. Yes, the Sikhs deserve freedom. I hope with British help and progress, they shall achieve it.
Then why do they cry out for their king?
Britain has a duty to bring about peace. It is an enormous responsibility, and I value your guidance and advice, along with that of Parliament. But it's our burden to rule India. And certainly not the duty of a forgotten leader who has not seen his country for 20 years. I apologize for being so frank, but one must not tell lies to a king.
Your honesty is most enlightening.
When I become Prime Minister, I intend to push for peace, but it will be a long and slow process. And I am afraid I can almost guarantee you will never see India again.
If my people are free, then my imprisonment shall be no burden.
Perhaps your idealism is real. Although, after observing the tigers wandering the grounds of your lush, expensive estate, forgive me for doubting it.
That's it.
Much luck, Your Highness, with your lobbying. I hope my advice has done some good.
Far more than your policies thus far. But I hold out hope that you will make progress. My people are counting on it. Thank you, Miss Fry, for forwarding my cause.
Oh, you are welcome. I hope some good comes of it, despite Mr. Gladstone's vitriol.
Those of us with the largest hearts protect them the most. Your father, for instance. From what I understand, he was extraordinarily sad, broken even, after your mother's passing. That kind of pain can blind us, cause us to say outlandish things to protect the ones we love. It's time you returned this carriage and recovered those plans. They are located in Buckingham Palace. The Queen keeps them among her personal papers in the White Drawing Room. I wish you a good evening, Miss Evie Fry.
And to you, Your Highness.
How's your brother? Not dead yet, I hope.
Excellency. There you are. A little the worse for wear.